This is the ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. Tonight at historic Mackey Arena, it's the undefeated NC State Wolfpack at 6-0 against 5-1 Purdue. As the Wolfpack look to get that first win on the board this year for the ACC. Let's take a look at the starting lineup for North Carolina State. Trevor Lacy, the transfer from Alabama, team's leading scorer, 17 points a game. Lenard Freeman and B.J. Anya, with his reach of 7'9", anchor the front court for NC State. On the other side for Purdue, their lone loss to K-State, a 9-point game. John Octi is the graduate transfer from Colorado State, joins Kendall Stevens and Raphael Davis. Vince Edwards, the freshman, the team's leading scorer at 13 points a game. And the 7-footer, A.J. Hammonds, who led the Big Ten in blocks, in the starting five as well. 10th year now for Matt Painter as the head coach here at Purdue. 70-5 at home against non-conference opponents, and a great mark in the ACC Big Ten Challenge as well. And an equally successful head coach on the other side for the Wolfpack in Mark Gottfried. Fourth year now for Gottfried, 1-2, going up against ACC Big Ten Challenge opponents. Natalie Dressed here tonight. He's taken them to three straight NCAA tournament appearances and looking for a fourth this year. Glad to have you along, Mike Cousins, along with former college hoops coach Stan Heath. And it's the Wolfpack with Cat Barber, the basketball, to get us going tonight.
Purdue starts in their man-to-man defense. They started the season a little bit more in a 2-3 zone, but since they've gone man, I think their defense has really picked up.
First shot for Turner just beyond the free throw line, and then drops in for the redshirt senior from Muscle Shoals, Alabama.
Yeah, Ralston Turner, he was the team's leading scorer, returning scorer from last season. He's a steady force at the guard position for NC State.
And a whistle underneath the bucket. So the foul goes on B.J. Anya, his first. Wolfpack this year trying to replace the ACC Player of the Year, T.J. Warren, 25 points a game last year. And off the inbounds, Kendall Stevens misfires for the Boilermakers. Really 2-0 lead. Barber directing the offense.
I like this matchup up top. You've got John Octius and you got Cat Barber. Two quick guards. Octius a little bit longer in length, and you got Cat Barber, who's super fast.
Lacy works the edge as they try and get it inside to Anya. Shot clock now down to 7. Now to the double team, the big man. And he gives it away. Davis intercepts it and runs the floor with Octius to his right.
Nice job by Davis stepping into the passing lane and picking that pass off.
Now Davis right to the bucket, misses. Hammonds couldn't get it, and it's tipped away off the hands of Lenard Freeman. Stays with Purdue.
Now there's some terrific size inside. You're going to look at this battle inside with A.J. Hammonds and B.J. and I. Two guys that B.J.'s got the girth, and A.J.'s 7-foot long. Good hands, good touch, good feel.
Inside Edwards through the double team, and the freshman scores. Number 89 player in his class in the ESPN 100 ties us at 2.
He's been a pleasant surprise for Matt Painter's team. The leading scorer, leading rebounder, a freshman right now, but does not play like a freshman and does a little bit of everything out there in the court for his team.
And Barber draws the foul as he goes to the floor.
Here's that last bucket by Vince Edwards. He just took his time, backed his man in, got through the double team and finished.
Foul on A.J. Hammonds for Purdue, his first and the team's first. Davis right back into the hands of Turner.
Boy, Davis is really active this early part of this game. He's their team's best defender. Right now, Purdue slips into a 2-3 zone right now. And you'll watch it with Davis. He's the guy that's talking, constantly kind of directing their defense out there on the court.
Anya found himself open underneath. And now another foul against the Boilermakers, who with Hammonds picking up his first, they brought in Isaac Haas, the big man.
Let's watch Anya right here. He's calling for the basketball, sliding underneath the rim, behind that zone. Great job by Trevor Lacy, finding him underneath, and he just got fouled by Haas.
Anya, the big man, who checks in at just under 300 pounds. They list him at 295, and they say he's dropped since coming to campus almost 60 pounds off of his frame, just a sophomore.
Yeah, just imagine. I mean, he's huge right now at 297, 295. Would have been about 350 if my math is 355. Holy smokes.
It's a load to get up and down the floor.
But those arms, I mean, that's incredible. 7'9" wingspan.
And Stan, now here's a little bit of an early conundrum that Matt Painter didn't want to face. He hasn't played Isaac Haas and A.J. Hammonds, the big men, on the floor together because of worries about foul trouble. Now each one has one.
Yeah, both guys have been getting in foul trouble, so they've been alternating their minutes. But Haas right there with the jump hook on the baseline.
Very talented freshman with his first 2 points of the night.
You know, Haas has been a pleasant surprise for Matt Painter's team. Had 11 points a game in about 18, 19 minutes.
Freeman misfires, and it's Davis running the break all the way to the bucket. And followed by the big man, drops it in, the trailer for two.
Well, I'd love to see the big fellas run the court. He went rim to rim and just finished that one.
And it is loud early here tonight at Mackey Arena. Barber shuffled to the outside. Now just five in the Wolfpack shot clock. Lacy from way outside.
Great defensive stand by Purdue. Did a great job of keeping the ball out of the paint and keeping shooters in front of him.
Stevens off the screen for three.
That's the guy right there. If you're Mark Godfrey, you don't want to see get going. He is a big-time shooter from the outside. A guy that's shooting over 40% from three. He can heat it up.
NC State trying to stop a 7-0 Boilermakers run. And Barber with his speed leaves it short in front of a 7-footer. And it's out of bounds. Boilermaker basketball.
Let's watch. Here's Haas inside. He's got two buckets right now. The first one posting up deep, showing those hands. Drop step with the right hand hook. And now he runs rim to rim, following the shot. And he just hammers it down.
Back at Mackey Arena, it's a 7-0 run for the Boilermakers as they lead 9-4 over the NC State Wolfpack. Glad to have you along. Stan Heath, Mike Cousins. There have been a lot of pleasant surprises this year for Purdue, but perhaps none larger physically than Isaac Haas.
Well, Matt Painter knew he got a terrific player in Isaac Haas when he signed him to come to Purdue, but he's getting a lot more than he originally thought he was going to get. After the tournament in Maui, you could just see this guy's progression just growing and growing and growing. He's playing with so much confidence, averaging 11 points. He's 7'2", and I'm giving him 300. They say 297, but he ate a lot for pregame, so I'm going to give him 300. But this guy right now can score with the right hand, the left hand. He does a great job of pinning and sealing down low.
True freshman, had originally verbally committed to Wake Forest, changed his mind, and now making an impact here with Purdue. Four out and one in, trying to feed the post, and Stevens has it swatted away by Kyle Washington. Haas keeps it alive, and he's going to the free throw line.
You know, once Haas gets those two paws wrapped around that basketball, you're not going to take it away from him. And I saw Matt Painter in practice yesterday. Just spent a lot of time with him, just working with keeping his elbows in. But right there, he takes the power dribble, and he goes up strong and gets fouled.
Haas right now leading the country in fouls drawn per 40 minutes. 9.8 fouls per 40 minutes.
That's a good sign right there. You know, he's been struggling a little bit at the free throw line. I think he went 0-for-5 in one of their games against Kansas State. The coaches said he went back to a local high school, got 300 up, so he's aware he's going to get fouled a lot and get himself to the free throw line.
Takes dedication to go shoot 300 free throws when you could go to the beach instead.
In Maui, of course.
6 points for Haas, more than half their total so far. Early lead for NC State, 9 unanswered for Purdue. And Washington gets it just inside the arc.
Yeah, that's Washington's range right there. He can shoot the three-pointer as well, too. He was starting the original part of the beginning of the season. He started the first three games. But he's more of a perimeter stretch four.
Haas through a double team, has it swatted off the window. And the follow comes from Edwards on the backside. Tomorrow, the ACC Big Ten Challenge is back on ESPN. First, Iowa takes on North Carolina, and that's followed by Jahlil Okafor and Duke taking on Frank Kaminsky and Wisconsin in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Iowa, UNC, and Duke against number 2, Wisconsin. Lots of good matchups in that game.
You know, as this game continues on, we really got to watch the rebounding in this game. NC State came in a plus 12 in rebounding during the beginning of this season. But right now, Purdue is dominating the glass. And with those two big guys inside, when you look at A.J. Hammonds and Isaac Haas, and Vince Edwards, he gets on the boards as well, too. If Purdue wins that battle, that could be the difference in this game.
Foul that precipitated the free throws was on Leonard Freeman. A 6-point lead for the Boilermakers. And the ball in the hands of Lacey, guarded by the freshman P.J. Thompson. Quite an assignment.
Whenever they take Cat Barber out of the team, Trevor Lacey slides over to the one. He's very comfortable running that position.
And what an addition he's been. 17 points a game in 34 minutes. Edwards looking for Thompson in the corner and off the hands of the true freshman, Caleb Martin. Out of bounds, here comes Hammonds back into the game for Purdue. And a rousing ovation, well deserved, for Haas.
That kid is so big and strong. He came in, as A.J. Hammonds is coming in, he slaps his hand 5. And A.J. starts shaking his hand like, man, that hurt. That's a hard 5.
Dakota Mathias the miss. Thompson follows it, gets the offensive rebound. Feed the post. Get it to the big man inside.
Nice pass. Nice wraparound 5-5 pass by E.J. Thomas. And the finish by A.J. Hammonds.
And a timeout taken by Mark Gottfried at NC State. Down by 8 on the road.
I like this wraparound bounce pass here by E.J. Hammonds. He just wraps it around Thompson, and he just finished it right there. A.J. Hammonds inside. The wraparound bounce pass was the whole key. Good job sealing and holding his ground by A.J. Hammonds.
So right now, the Big Ten out to a 4-0 advantage. Yesterday, Rutgers and Nebraska picking up wins, both on the road. Pretty impressive start, and Purdue carrying the torch here in the early going.
Yeah, good timeout by Mark Gottfried. His team right now is being out-hustled a little bit. Purdue seems a little quicker to the ball. They're getting a lot of offensive rebounds, and they have a lot more intensity on the defensive end. So his team has got to take a step up. It's not easy. This is their first road test, and right now they're not passing the test.
Wolfpack 6-0, but it's their first true road game of the season. And a whistle in the lane going back the other way.
Yeah, Ralston Turner extended those arms to create some separation. He didn't need to do that. That would have been a nice backdoor layup, but the offensive foul goes the other way.
So now 4 fouls against the Wolfpack. Turner, Washington, Freeman, and Anya each with 1. Hammonds. And still no good from 3 this year. 0 for 5 from beyond the arc for the big man.
Yeah, the big fella's been working hard on that shot, but it hasn't dropped for him this year yet.
Nice job left-handed finish from Washington, the sophomore from Minnesota, to get into the paint. A real concerted effort to work it around the outside. And there they go. They practiced that just a couple hours ago.
Purdue worked on several lob plays in their shoot-around today, and that was one of them. They picked up where NC State likes to go low on those cross screens, and they were just going to fake the cut and throw over the top to A.J. Hammonds.
Lacy creates as he fades away just beyond the elbow. This is a real point of emphasis this year for Purdue. Last year, you had Hammonds, a seven-footer, a legitimate NBA prospect, only got seven shots a game, and right now the offense is being designed for him.
Yeah, what's different in this year's team with Purdue, last year they didn't have a lot of perimeter outside shooting. They have more outside shooters with Vince Edwards being able to knock down shots, Stevens being able to knock down shots. So now the spacing is a lot better offensively, and it allows A.J. Hammonds and guys like Isaac Haas to operate and work in the low post.
After a 9-0 run, that's now five straight from the Wolfpack as they cut the Purdue lead to three. Mathias tries it again. Offensive rebounds here in the first 8 minutes for Purdue.
Yeah, that's a big concern right now for NC State. A lot of offensive rebounds, a lot of 50-50 balls going Purdue's way. Purdue out hustling them on those plays.
Already five boards on the offensive glass for the Boilermakers. Double team doesn't come. Hammonds turns and scores with the jump hook. Six for the junior.
Well, he was really patient. He got the ball. He read the defense. Solid. Bouncing the paint, easy jump hook over the left. He made it look so easy.
Caleb Martin misses everything except the window. Are they going to have to double team inside?
I think Martin's going to mix it up. He switched over to a 2-3 zone as well, too. I think he's going to have to mix and match it a little bit because right now he hasn't found the answer to stop Purdue.
And Mathias has the green light. He keeps it going. Better than 40% from deep on the year.
You know, it's funny, in their practice, I thought he was one of their top four players. And Matt just talked about how his kid's been struggling with some injuries and some illnesses through the summer. But this kid can shoot the basketball.
Motion from Washington gives it up to Martin. No good spacing there on the right side for NC State. Shot clock under 10, and Lacy too strong. Shot clock still going. Nothing ever hit the rim. They've got to get a shot off, and it's out of bounds. They got 1 second left.
A.J. Hammonds on the inside right now for Purdue, posting up, taking his time, reading the defenders. That easy jump hook right over that left shoulder. Now we have Mr. Outside, Dakota Mathias, for the three ball in the corner.
Coming up tomorrow on ESPN, a top five showdown between Frank Kaminsky, Wisconsin, Jahlil Okafor from Duke, and then Friday, Miles Turner and Texas travel to Lexington to face the nation's top-ranked team, the Kentucky Wildcats. A couple of early season matchups this week on ESPN. This is the one that everybody's been talking about, Coach. You had a freshman and a senior and two very different styles of play.
Yeah, well, first, that's a Final Four matchup when you look at those two programs. But these two guys right now, so evenly matched with their numbers, but so different in the way they play. And we'll talk about that.
I'm very curious, listening to Bo Ryan on the ESPN College Basketball podcast with Andy Katz and Seth Greenberg. He goes, look, it's just another game for us where they play so well at home.
Yeah, here are my thoughts about these two guys. You got a freshman versus senior. That's the obvious. Traditional big. Okafor likes to play around the basket. He's got great offensive moves, right-hand jump hook, quick spin moves, the old-school big guy, and the stretch big, which is now infused in basketball right now. At all levels, when you look at Frank Kaminsky, a guy who can stretch out, shoot the three ball, as well as play inside.
And who keeps his own block, putting him in his own category for sure. Shot clock expires. No whistle, that's off the foot of Hammonds.
Tough and break right there.
Gene Steratore says it stays here. Now, Matt Painter has a point here. The shot clock expired. The shot had not been taken. And he wants it to be Purdue basketball because as it stands now, it would go back to NC State.
Well, here's the thing on that. You're allowed to catch and shoot with 1 second.
But the light is already on.
That's a good point right there. They may go to the monitor and have to review this.
Oh, the ball comes inbounds
and the ball is not even in the shooter's hand.
Well, the clock shouldn't start till the ball is in the shooter's hand. I think that's where they're having the discussion right now. If he double pumped it or he kind of held it and fumbled it, that's one thing. But if he just caught it and shot it, you're allowed to get a shot off in 1 second.
Matt Painter has played so well against non-conference opponents, trying to bring this team back to its prominence from years past, back-to-back losing season. So here it comes in.
See, the clock started. The lights light up right here. You can see right here. It lights up before the ball is even in possession right here. So that's where that was the scoring error right there, the clock, shot clock. Went a little bit early on that.
So the always excellent Gene Steratore gives us the explanation that the clock started early, so they'll basically redo the play.
And he called it a clock malfunction. I think somebody pushed that button a little bit too soon, but we'll call it a clock malfunction.
Underneath Washington, rejected by Hammonds. And now the shot clock violation that the Purdue bench wanted.
You know, I think Purdue caught a break on that, because had the shot clock not been a malfunction, the ball would have been off Purdue's foot and have been NC State's ball with 35 more seconds. But right here, on the baseline of bounds, nice pass inside, but A.J. Hammonds comes into play and gets a piece of that. Goes straight up and down. It's a very good shot blocker, long arms, good timing.
Third turnover for NC State, under 10 and a half to go in the first half. Basil Smotherman off the bench for the first time. Kendall Stevens tries to light it up from deep. Scoring board from Washington, and Lacey pushes it. Strong finish from the freshman. Caleb Martin
caught a break on that. He was up in the air, kind of hanging around, figuring out what to do, and he dropped it off for the score.
It's the old coaching point. Don't move your feet if you don't know where you're going to go with it.
No. He got away with that. The dude does a nice job with their ball movement. They rarely utilize the dribble unless they're going somewhere with it. Most of the time, that ball is firing around side to side on the perimeter.
Good defensive stand, and Martin takes it away. First turnover of the night for the Boilermakers. Foul in front of the bench. That's on Octius, his first.
A.J. Hammonds is off to a great start right now, and he's done a good job posting up inside, his teammates finding him with great low post position. Here on the lob play, just carving out space and nice patience in the post with a jump hook over the left shoulder.
Fouls on Smotherman, so Octius no foul. Smotherman, the sophomore from Indianapolis, charged with his first and the third against Purdue. Cat Barber at the point guard spot, started there last season, lost that spot for the final 14 games on a team that went to the NCAA tournament, lost in the second round to St. Louis.
He switched it to a 2-3 zone here, and they've got NC State standing around.
Both Martin brothers on the floor. Washington, baseline drive, hangs and delivers.
You know, Washington's been a bright spot right now for NC State. He's got 6 points. He's hit the free throw line jump shot, and right here he goes inside. Nice little move around the baseline.
Back to Hammonds, and he walked with it.
Yeah, Washington here along the baseline. He gets a shot fake right now. Not even a shot fake. He just catches and goes, pulls up. He's left-handed. Nice soft touch.
So Hammonds comes off, and Haas is back in. Nice start for him. 6 points in the early going.
That's an area where A.J. Hammonds has had some problems for the year with his high turnovers. And it's really a lot of it's been footwork. Just shuffling those feet, getting a little bit antsy, trying to do too much too soon.
Barber got into the lane, and then a foul goes with Martin in the air, and that's against Kendall Stevens, his first, fourth against Purdue.
Kendall Stevens just gets underneath him, Gets it with the body down low. It's a good call by the officials. Not a smart foul right there by Kendall Stevens. You never want to foul a three-point shooter.
Martin now at the line, 5 of 9 on the year. He's got 3 points.
Yeah, Martin was a highly recruited kid, ranked 62 in ESPN's top 100.
Played for the legendary head coach Steve Smith at Oak Hill Academy. Came here with his brother Cody. Even their parents have trouble telling them apart. Hey. Born 1 minute apart, and you stand next to them, you have no idea who's who.
I told the NC State coaching staff, please don't put them in at the same time. Outside of the numbers, we're going to have problems. And lo and behold, they're in at the same time.
Five now for Caleb as the Wolfpack have scratched their way to back within one. Haas doubled, quickly gets it out for Edwards. Purdue's leading scorer. Short, second try, is in.
Nice
16 second chance points for Purdue.
He stayed with his shot. Nice drive to the middle of the floor, missed it, but stayed with the shot for the easy putback.
Washington had good position outside Cody Martin. Off glass, no, gets his own board, and fouled on the second try, going up. Back and forth they go. NC State looking for the ACC's first win in this year's ACC Big Ten Challenge.
He has a better approach now than he did when he came in. You know, he's in great shape. He's down to about 255 pounds, and that's a big step for him. But you know, not just he's a guy that wants to compete on a Wednesday night and a Saturday afternoon, but getting him to go every single day. And really limiting the distractions, and you know he is starting to understand that part of it. You know, the fewer distractions he can have, the more consistent he's going to be.
That's Purdue head coach Matt Painter on AJ Hammond's 6 points and a renewed focus this year. He talks about off the floor distractions. Hammond's got suspended in the early portion of Purdue's season last year, but with Isaac Haas, the 7-foot freshman coming in, that's given him competition day in and day out.
Yeah, I think that's very important for him. And he talked about, you know, just having outside distractions, just so many people in your ear, and it's really important to stay focused. Stay focused on basketball, stay focused on academics, but you're right. It also sounds like practice. He's a game guy, and coaches get frustrated with that. I know I did when guys don't bring it every single day in practice. But now with a guy like Isaac Haas, when you don't produce every day, you're not bringing it all the time. It's easy now for Matt Painter to say, hey, you know what? Come have a seat by me and watch how it's done.
Last year the options were not quite as good. They had Jay Simpson, but he was limited in the early part of the season, and then his career unfortunately came to an early end due to a heart condition, but now two true huge posts. And there's a three from Vince Edwards.
That kid's been so steady, so steady. He just does it in a lot of different ways. We saw him drive the ball earlier. Now he steps out, gets the feet set, and drills the three.
8 points for Edwards. Mismatch there with Haas guarding Martin. They get back. Another man-to-man defense. Haas the rebound. Davis thought about the three, 15-footer.
That's a good shot for Davis. That's about his range at about 15 feet. He's not necessarily a three-point shooter. More of a defender, but a guy who can kind of slash and hit 15-foot shots.
Martin drives, and it's short. In a way, looking like Purdue's guard offense did last year, into the lane, not necessarily anywhere to go with it.
I think the difference right now offensively is Purdue is going inside, they're getting ball movement, they're getting ball reversal. NC State's playing a little bit more one-on-one basketball. Here's Purdue on offense. You can see the ball movement going side to side, the reversal. You got Edwards spotted up with his 2 feet, and he just knocks down that three-point shot.
That one. Off the miss by Haas. It's Edwards at the free throw line where he's shooting 88% this season. Foul was on Anthony Catbarber, his first. Edwards a pretty good pickup as well. You talk about Haas, 7'2" player. Edwards ranked number 89 in the ESPN 100 and chose Purdue over Michigan, Xavier, and Dayton.
And he's a tough matchup because he looks more like a small forward, but they have to play in that power forward position. But he can play inside, he can play outside, he defends. If they want, they can switch 1-4 with a guy like him. And he's holding his own on the rebounding end, giving up a lot of size and weight most games.
Lacey steps into the triple, 5 now for the redshirt junior out of Huntsville, Alabama. NC State had gotten the back within one, and Mathias with the three extends the lead. 9-point edge for the Boilermakers.
This could be a breakout game by Dakota Mathias. He's a guy who can really shoot the basketball, knows how to play. As I mentioned earlier, he was ill and had some illnesses that made him not ready to go in the early part of the season, but now he's full go. And he was very good in their practice yesterday.
Some confusion on offense for the Wolfpack. 5 on the shot clock. Barber guarded by Thompson. Put on the line. Offensive rebound tipped around by Anya. 300-pounder. Everybody gets out of the way wisely.
Boy, Anya with the big-time offensive rebounding. He took one dribble and the seat parted. I mean, everybody just got out of the way.
Keep in mind, since he got to campus, he's lost 60 pounds.
Yeah, BJ just hustles this ball down, and he takes two dribbles and just attacks the rim. Good hustle by BJ Anya. That's what we call a smackdown.
Anya down this end of the floor picks up his second foul. 6 against North Carolina State, 5 against Purdue, and the Boilermakers up by 7 with 4:30 to go in the first half. E.J. Thompson up top. Boilermakers without one of their reserve guards. Bryson Scott is out tonight with an ankle injury. And a traveling violation called on Edwards. Third turnover for Purdue. And Saturday, it'll be interstate rivals. VCU and Virginia looking forward to that one. Another ACC team going at it.
Got some great matchups in this ACC Big Ten challenge. I mean, every game has a lot of weight to it.
That foul called on PJ Thompson, his first.
The rotation was a little bit slow getting over there for Purdue on the bounce pass in by Freeman. He got a piece of it right there on EJ Thompson. Good job giving help just a little bit late.
Bernard Freeman, the sophomore out of Washington, D.C. One of the younger guys in his class. He won't turn 19 until next Wednesday. One big man for another. Haas sits and Hammond's back in.
Boy, what a luxury Matt Painter has to just keep rotating those two bigs back and forth. And I'm sure at some point in time, because they talked about how they've been working in practice to try to integrate those two guys together.
How many coaches can go to alternating seven-footers?
I don't know of many. And seven-footers that are very good players, that are both guys that can score and rebound and play inside.
Stevens turns and just misses. Back to NC State. Stan, I think you make a good point there. Is there a decent number of players in college basketball who are 7 feet or taller but don't necessarily have the developed skill sets that these two players do?
And I think that's a surprising thing that Matt Payne and his staff feel about Isaac Hayes. They didn't think offensively he would be so advanced. And he's come in averaging 11 points a game, being very effective.
Purdue has ridden their way to a lead by five. 16 at second chance points for the Boilermakers here at home at Mackey Arena. Glad to have you along, Mike Cousins and Stan Heat. We talked about how some of the big men, A.J. Hammonds, have played along with Isaac Haas for Purdue. On the other side, as you take us here inside the play, you talk about big men having to pass out of the post. It's not always so easy to do.
Oh, not at all, especially when you have good defense out there on the court and you got Purdue playing a pack line type defense. On the play right here, you see how the defenders are now collapsed in the lane, and now it allows that offensive player right here, he's a little confused, and he makes that pass, and Purdue just shoots the gap and steals that for a great defensive sequence for Purdue.
Rafael Davis stepped in there and took it away. And right now, that's where the advantage has lied with that rotation of seven footers for Matt Painter and the Boilermakers. Before the whistle, it was a foul on Kendall Stevens, his second. So now NC State into the bonus, 17 fouls against Purdue. And it's Cat Barber at the free throw line, earns himself a second. Barber, for his size, 6'2", 180 pounds. That's his team leading 44th free throw attempt. So his speed is what allows him to get to the free throw line when he penetrates the lane.
He's a guy that he just needs a small seam. He can get through a seam, get to the basket. He's there so quick, a lot of times the defense is late. And he either gets fouled or he finishes plays around the basket.
Matthias. Already good two times from beyond the arc. Leaves that one just off.
Well, I tell you what, BJ and I is just battling inside with both bigs. I mean, he's got to take turns. He's got A.J. Hammond one time, and he's got Isaac Haas. And I tell you what, on that one last play when he hustled down and got the rebound and dunked it, they need to reward him. Let him get a few touches and see if he can help them a little bit offensively.
Saturday, it'll be interstate rivals in the Commonwealth. Justin Anderson leads number 7 Virginia against Coach Shaka Smart's high-energy VCU squad. Anderson at 15 points a game leads Virginia against VCU as part of Jimmy V Week. 2:40 to go here at Mackey Arena in the first half, and Purdue up by 3. NC State has come right to the doorstep. Only to see Purdue grow its lead a couple times. And a traveling violation against Anya. So they took your advice. Yeah, they fed the big man.
But hey, it's okay. They should go back to him. He was a little bit eager. He hadn't touched in a little while. And before he got it, he just shuffled those feet, tried to make a quick move. The same thing happened to A.J. Hammonds on the other end. Just catch it, read the defense, slow down a little bit, and then you have the opportunity to make the move.
And Anya goes right back to the bench. You get a breather and a tutorial. Three ball. Vince Edwards does it again into double digits for the freshman out of the Buckeye State.
Well, he's having a terrific game. What a great start. 11 points right now, and he seems so comfortable at that three-point line. Well, Washington's right there posted up. Wants the ball, and he's been a bright spot for NC State, Washington. You know, Collins can play inside and play outside. I thought they were going to give him the ball on the low post, but he stepped out and still got that 15-footer.
Three seconds called against Purdue.
You got Kyle Washington right here posting up. He didn't get it. So he steps out of the high post and right inside the three-point line and sticks the shot. This is the old UCLA cut. Guard shuffle cuts right off of Washington. Defense has to help a little bit, and it opens up that 17-footer.
To the edge, Barber. Thompson with him step for step. He hangs and hits. Nice shot there for Barber, a 6'2" guard.
Good shot by Barber. You know, he's got that speed to get in the lane, and he consistently can get in there and knock down those little 12-footers. That's a difficult cover for anybody.
Davis, baseline. And it's an offensive foul.
Nice job by Turner, rotating over and stepping in, taking that charge for NC State.
First on Davis. Coming up at the break, the guys in studio. We'll look at highlights from other games in the ACC, Big Ten Challenge. And they'll preview tomorrow night's Duke and Wisconsin showdown. And then there's a shakeup in Big Ten football. Coaching change at Michigan, one of many high-profile jobs open, and that's coming up at the half. NC State with a chance to take the lead on this possession. Washington, a little too strong. And now Purdue can hold for the last shot of the half. And Matt Painter takes a timeout. John Octia has had the ball there. The transfer who's been so highly touted has yet to take a shot so far in the half. Hasn't needed to, really, with the way that everybody else has been scoring, especially the duo of Haas and Hammonds. So far, the Big Ten undefeated. Now, go back to last year, it was a split between the two conferences. Back-to-back years now, it's been 6-6 with the Big Ten winning three out of the last five. So you had wins. Minnesota winning over Wake Forest, pretty big. And then how about a pretty young Indiana team taking down Pitt, an 81-69 win.
Boy, they really controlled that game, you know, for 40 minutes. Good win by Indiana. Looks like those young guys are really coming along for Tom Crean.
This is a young Purdue team as well. Let's not forget on scholarship, Matt Painter right now is working with two juniors, three sophomores, and five freshmen.
Yeah, he's got a very young team, and some of those young players, you're going to have Vince Edwards and Isaac Haas, they're playing key roles in significant minutes and major production for their team. Leading scorer, Vince Edwards, right here. That was one of those lose-it or use-it timeouts right there. Get this last shot.
NC State has scored 13 of the last 19 points. Who do you think they look for here?
Well, you know, Vince Edwards has been hot. Wouldn't be surprised if he comes into the play.
Here's Edwards with the ball. Thompson, gotta get a shot off. Three-pointer is no good. And so as the ACC looks for its first win in the challenge this year, they're down by a pair. Purdue leads 36-34 at the break. This is the ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. We welcome you back to West Lafayette, Indiana, where Purdue has a two-point lead over NC State. Stan Heath, Mike Cousins, glad to have you along here on this Tuesday night. And so far we've seen Vince Edwards, the leading scorer in this game for Purdue, with 13 points. NC State clinging in there. They've never been able to get that lead back.
Yeah, Purdue got off to a great start, and Vince Edwards has been terrific. He's knocked down two threes right now. The three-point shot for Purdue has probably been the difference in this game. NC State's been able to hang on with the free throw situation, but you can see right here, great ball movement by Purdue. And right there, you've got Stevens knocking down that shot. You got Dakota Mathias, who came off the bench and knocked down two big threes as well, too. But Vincent Edwards, the leading scorer, has carried the Boilermaker offense by doing it from the three-point shot as well as by driving it to the basket.
Free throw is a big difference right now. NC State, 10 of 11 at the line. But those second chance points, at one point, that was 16-0 in favor of the Boilermakers.
Yeah, and it was also an 8-point lead for the Boilermakers at that time when they were dominating the class. NC State, the last 10 minutes, has just grinded themselves back into this game. A lot of it was some hustle plays, some stick backs, and a lot of free throw shooters by attacking off the bounce.
Earn it. Ready to go for the second half. The ACC yet to get a win in this year's ACC Big Ten Challenge. Can the Wolfpack stay undefeated? 6-0. Coming into the night, Purdue at 5-1. Their only loss against Kansas State. A Purdue club that went 2-1 at the EA Sports Maui Invitational. And the offense on the right foot, Ralston Turner fouls Kendall Stevens.
That's a horrible foul right there. I mean, he just comes from behind, tries to block the shot, and he just hits him in the back in the head. I mean, he's a senior. He can't make a play like that for no reason.
So second foul on Turner, and Stevens at the free throw line where he's been 79% on the year. Guy back at full health this year. Played last year with some shoulder issues, a groin issue. But still started 16 times. He's got five on the night.
No, Akis has been quiet in this game, but he's done a nice job defensively because Cat Barber on the other side really hasn't done a lot for NC State.
Barber right now with only 4 points. Sophomore point guard. Nice passing touch. And it's Anya going to the free throw line.
Yeah, that was all keyed by the trap. Purdue was downing the ball screen, pushing it to the sideline. And once that did, there was two guys on one. Lacey did a good job of getting the ball to the middle of the floor with the flash from Freeman. And Freeman just with a touch pass right on top by BJ and Allen.
And Stan, they found a way to do what's been somewhat difficult tonight is get A.J. Hammonds out of the paint, open up the lane for Anya.
Well, if you're NC State, that's a great strategy with both of those bigs is bring them away from the basket. They're very comfortable around the basket, rebounding, playing post defense, but put them in ball screens, lift them up with a shooter. Washington was very effective in this game when he came in. He knocked down some shots. He's got 6 points for NC State, and that's because he's pulling those bigs away from the basket.
Reach-in foul on Rayfield Davis. And now some contact after the whistle between Davis and Lacey. And Bill Eck getting in there to quickly defuse the situation. Gene Steratore trying to get it stopped. Back at midcourt, it was Octius hitting the deck.
This all kind of started at half court. You've got the knockdown play right there. It's getting a little bit physical going into the second half. It was a hard legal foul. It wasn't anything dirty. Lacey didn't like the contact, but it wasn't anything dirty by Rafael Davis on that play.
After the foul, Boilers still lead by two. Ball knocked away. It stays with the Wolfpack as Turner tries to get it in.
Yeah, I like this. You know, hey, guys getting a little tense, getting a little chippy. Trying to fight and win this game.
And it's not like these two teams play often. They've played four times ever. NC State has won each and every time.
Great defense by Rafael Davis. He's all over.
Contested shot. Turner rejected by both Stevens and Hammonds.
Well, Stevens wanted to let that go. He just bobbled that pass.
One-on-one, up and under. Seven-footer can't finish the first time. Second time is good.
Good job by Hammond staying with the play. He missed the first shot, but had the presence to just go right back at the rim and keep the ball alive and score it.
First true road game of the year for the Wolfpack.
I think Coach Godfrey went in at halftime, and he's trying to get a concerted effort to get Lacey involved offensively and get him going. He's their star player.
With five to shoot, Lacey from the outside, a deadly touch. 8 points now for the redshirt junior.
You know, I had a nice talk with him before the game, and, you know, I just talked about how was it that you just, you know, sat out a year and just come into this season, and it's been such a smooth transition. And he just said he paid attention last year when he sat out. He watched, he listened, he heard everything that Coach Godfrey was preaching to some of the other guys, and he didn't want to make those same mistakes, and he learned the system.
Foul was on Ralston Turner, his third, and it's Stevens back to the line. Second leading scorer in the early going for this squad, 12 points a game. Five tonight, just one of five shooting. Caleb Martin, the freshman from Moxville, North Carolina, back into the ballgame. They're expecting Stevens to be a big three-point weapon, something they've lacked over the last couple of years. Coming into the game, shooting 49% from three, give him six on the night.
Yeah, he's a little off today, but he is a knockdown three-point shooter. And he really elevates on that jump shot. He doesn't need a lot of time and a lot of space. NC State has done a good job just kind of tagging him, shadowing him to make sure he doesn't get loose.
5 points the last two possessions for Lacey.
Well, you just wonder when you get a little scrum, a little scrap like that between him and Davis, that kind of set Trevor Lacey off, and it's kind of pushed some buttons to get him going.
Martin hauls it in, and now the Wolfpack with a chance to take their first lead since it was 2-0. And Barber will go to the free throw line to try and do just that.
It's a great job right here by Trevor Lacey, curling off the screen, continuing to attack the basket in the paint, and gets a nice, soft, kind bounce off the rim. I like about him is he's not just a three-point shooter. He can put it on the floor. He can pass it. He's a good all-around offensive player.
It really helps their rotation. The loss of Tyler Lewis, their point guard last year, who transferred to Butler after the season was over. Mark Gottfried says he looks at him as like a coach on the floor.
You know, the other thing he mentioned was, because I said, you look very comfortable when you slide over to the point. He said, Coach, I'm a natural point guard. It just so happens every time I play, I always play with a really good point guard, and I shoot, so they slide me over. He said, but he's very comfortable playing the point guard position.
Hammonds with position and one.
There's A.J. Hammonds right there. He does a great job just getting position, a nice big target, showing his hands. He doesn't bring the ball down at all. He keeps it up high and finishes it high at the basket.
Now 11 for Hammonds. So NC State had a chance to take the lead. A couple of missed free throws. And Cat Barber brings it over midcourt. Purdue by three. Raphael Davis fired up on the defensive end. Step for step with Lacey on the perimeter. Washington from three. He got it.
Boy,
just his second made three of the year.
Hey, he wants that starting position back. You know, he was an early starter. He's having a heck of a ball game for NC State.
That brings the Wolfpack back to a 44 all time. The goal is clear. Feed A.J. Hammonds.
That's the second time right there. A.J. Hammonds has missed his shot and got his own rebound. After he shoots it, you've got to put a body and box him out.
Good ball movement, but an empty possession for Purdue. Martin floats. Offensive foul.
Nice job right there. Kyle Washington for NC State has been on a tear with a 17-foot jump shot. It's butter.
Purdue, NC State. They squared off 2004 in the ACC Big Ten Challenge in Raleigh. NC State struggled from the field, but, and a big one, Julius Hodge emerged for the Wolfpack. 22 points. Patented jump stop right there. 8 rebounds, 5 assists, and a 60-53 win over Purdue. There's Herb Sendek, Gene Cady. NC State 2-0. They're at Mackey Arena. They've only got one road win, though, in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. That's in 99. Since then, they've lost to Ohio State, Michigan twice, Iowa, Michigan State, and Wisconsin. So 5-2 at home, but only 1-6 away from Raleigh.
I like that old school jump stop. I haven't seen that in a while. You know, everybody does the Euro steps, but going back now, the old school jump stop off 2 feet, that's fundamentals.
Now for Mark Gottfried, we've talked about it's the first true road game of the year for his club.
Each of his first three seasons, they've lost the first true road game, but they've challenged themselves. Stanford, Michigan, Cincinnati, and now a much better Purdue team than in the last couple of years. Out of bounds and headed back the other way.
Scheduling is just so important, the non-conference scheduling. And now it's even bigger this season, because if you don't play good competition in the non-conference, then you will get penalized if you're a team that's on the board to get to the NCAA tournament as an at-large.
And that's been a stated goal of the Wolfpack. Wins over Richmond and Boise State in their last two games. Martin gets rid of it. Washington, power dribble, short. Offensive board, and he gets the second chance try.
Yeah, I think I can hear the crowd. They thought there was going to be an over-the-back call, but he just went straight up and was quick to the ball and finished.
First lead for NC State since it was 2-0. Haas pushed from behind, counted it in.
Watch Haas right here flash and post up and seal the defender. An easy pass over the top and a nice soft touch by Isaac Haas. He's so big and carves out so much space, it's hard to get around him.
Look at the hands here on Washington too.
Yeah, I mean, it was an easy call right there with the push.
And that's why you hear the crowd booing right now. Well, because it looked like there was some intent with that.
Well, the thing is, there wasn't a play on the ball. That's the thing. He never went after the basketball. He just pushed him. And that's what's going to be interesting. They're going to go to the monitor and review this.
Okay, so as Billack and Gene Steratore go over to the monitor to watch this replay, what do they have to decide here?
Well, this is an interesting call right here, because the call on the floor was just foul and one, shoot free throws. But they're going to the monitor to see if this is a flagrant with excessive contact. They have a point here to change this to a flagrant one.
Every possession looms large here. Still plenty of time, 14-18 to go second half. But NC State just took its first lead since the game's opening minute. You don't want to give away points and possession.
No, not at all. I mean, that's a silly foul right there. He had him totally beat. Just concede the layup right there. You can see right here the push in the back. And that's why they're going to the monitor, because if it's excessive contact and he's not making a play on the basketball, it's a flagrant one. I think they're going to have to give him a couple free throws. Excessive, unnecessary contact, not a legitimate play on the ball, or push from behind. That's a flagrant one. I think the rule is very clear right there. It'll be interesting what they do here.
So it just stays as a common foul.
Yeah, that's surprising. When you look at the definition of the rule, everything that's in that rule for flagrant one appears to be a flagrant one call.
Haas not deterred. Knocks down the free throw. 9 for the freshman. Barber, quick pace. And Haas wipes it off the cylinder. Now, Matt Painter's going to try and argue that it was already off the cylinder. It looked like it was sitting on top of the rim.
It was so close, and it wasn't going in. So now NC State gets rewarded with a bucket right here, but it's hanging right on the rim. Yeah, it's a good call by the official.
Foul on Barber. His second and the sixth against the Wolfpack. Just 3 called on Purdue here in the second half. That's a tough spot where not many people play at that height. If you're a 7-footer, you have to be well aware of those rules.
You have to lay off of that, but that is tough because it's right there and it looks like it's coming off.
Matthias, and he's fouled. Well, Saturday at 4, ESPNU brings you the Southwest Athletic Conference Championship. Southern tries to repeat. They go up against Alcorn State. It's college football primetime presented by McDonald's. Saturday on ESPNU and also available live on Watch ESPN. Alcorn on the regular season matchup between those two. Foul goes on Caleb Martin, his second. That's now 7, so it puts Purdue into the bonus
here just 4 minutes into the second half.
Yeah, that's not the position you want to be at any time, especially on the road. To be in the bonus this early is a bonus for Purdue. And, you know, they've got those two big guys inside, so anytime they go inside, there's a good chance they're going to get fouled.
Still anybody's game at this point. Martin driving high off the window, and again. He's on the floor trying to take it away. Haas has it for the Boilermakers. Fires a good night. 7 points. 2 of 4 from beyond the arc. They run him off looking for his third three.
Boy, he had a good look at that. Just didn't go down. Good offense by Purdue. Moving the ball side to side.
High-low action. And a reaching foul called against Purdue. 16th year of the ACC Big Ten Challenge. And the last score to roll in, Michigan with a 3-point win over Syracuse in Ann Arbor, pushing it to a 5-0 lead for the Big Ten. And right now, Louisville and Ohio State at the break. That game over on ESPN. Mathias, his first foul, fourth, against the Boilermakers.
The dude just slid into a 2-3 zone on that baseline out of bounds. They've got to locate the shooters. You've got to know where Lacey is at all times. And Turner's a good 3-point shooter also.
Lacey's with it at the top of the key. Pulls up before he reaches Haas, who's got the rebound. No numbers though for Thompson.
Good job on transition defense by NC State. And good job by Thompson. Recognized the defense was back and didn't force anything.
NC State from number 10. Foul goes on Bernard Freeman, number 2, on the sophomore out of Washington, D.C.
And that's the one thing in this game. We haven't seen a lot of fast break points. Both teams really doing a good job of getting their defense set. Guys sprinting back, stopping the basketball, and really locating and fogging the paint, locating the shooters up there on the floor.
Kendall Stevens off the bench, and Mathias takes a seat. Here comes a second free throw for Raphael Davis, who in the last two games made 24 free throws. Those are the first two he shot tonight.
Yeah, he shot 29 out of those, and just a guy that just been going to the basket, attacking, really known to be their defensive guy, and the guy that has been guarding Trevor Lacy the majority of this game, but since Trevor now slid over to the point, you've got Thompson on him.
NC State down by one. Haas continues to dominate the glass.
Well, it's one and done. Haas just, when he's in the paint and the shot goes up, either side, he's just grabbing those rebounds.
7 boards for Haas, and a one-handed finish.
Just think about that. Hopefully BJ and I's okay. I think he's checking his tooth. Hey, you've got 600 pounds down low with the 9 Haas. Haas just carves out space and attacks the rim for the finish.
Purdue with a 3-point lead as they try and send NC State to their first loss. Freshman Isaac Haas, size 22 shoes, has been the biggest man on the floor tonight.
Well, he just posts up so well. He's big and wide. He's an easy target. And he's doing a good job making some hustle plays, running the floor from rim to rim. And he's just dominated the glass. He's got 7 rebounds right now. Every defensive rebound, when it goes up, is his. And right there again, he just carves out space, spreads his wings, and finishes strong.
Like he's getting set for live action Peter Pan. That's two nights from now. So the Oregon Ducks, they play fast. Their offensive line, 296 pounds. Haas, he might make a good tackle there. 297. A.J. Hammonds, 261. Oregon, by the way, number two in the new college football playoff rankings. Only 1 week left for that, but that just gives you an idea of the size of these guys. They are football player weight in a basketball player's body.
Yeah, at 7'2", though, you don't want to go out on the gridiron. I mean, he's so big. You know, the thing you like about him is, I mean, it's his body fat, I think, is like 5%. I mean, he's got no wasted fat anywhere. I mean, this guy is put together. He's fit. He's got good hands. He runs the floor, and he's really learned at a young age how to use that body.
Anya turns, contested look.
That's what's so difficult. You know, you have to shoot over the top of a 7'2" guy, and you just don't get a good look. Anya just kind of threw that up there. He never really got a good, clean look at the rim.
Little handoff for Thompson. No points for him tonight. From Mackey Arena in West Lafayette, Indiana, Stan Heath, Mike Cousins. Glad you could be with us tonight. And it has been close all evening between Purdue and NC State. Boilermakers 5-1. NC State 6-0. Now on P.J. Thompson is his second.
Yeah. P.J. right here. I mean, he's trying to get up into Trevor Lacy. I think he got all ball on that play right there. E.J. was a little frustrated on that call right there. Put it on the floor. But Purdue has done a nice job with Rafael Davis and E.J. Thompson just rotating different guys and staying attached to him, not giving him much space anytime he moves without the basketball. That's a good call. You know, that's where A.J. Hammond is just having a little bit of trouble. He shuffles those feet. When you look at his turnover numbers, he's got over 20 turnovers, and a lot of it's just like that play right there. He just shuffles his feet, trying to do something too quick too soon.
We apologize for our technical difficulties. Stan Heath, Mike Cousins, here with you at Mackey Arena, home of the Purdue Boilermakers. They lead by three. Foul against Purdue. That's on, looks like Rafael Davis. Or P.J. Thompson, beg your pardon, his third. NC State out to a 2-0 lead. They did not lead again until here in the second half, so the margin has not been big for either side as Purdue tries to make it 6-0 for the Big Ten in the challenge between these two conferences. Washington goes to work. The southpaw short, and a tip in by Anya gets the bucket. 1-point game.
Nice follow by Anya. Nobody boxed him out, and he just went right to the basket. Got those 7'9" wingspan up in the air and tipped it in.
Hammonds had it, but before he got it, foul on the floor.
Watch Anya right here make the rim run when the shot goes up. Nobody boxed him out. He goes right to the basket. He's too big to just get a free lane going to the rim on offensive rebound. Somebody's got to put a body on. That's A.J. Hammond. He's got to go find him and put a body on him and box Anya out.
Now, here's some trouble. Anya just picked up his fourth foul. So they're going to have to find a way to counter size for size on the inside. And it's still 9:50 to go midway through this second half.
Well, Washington's had a nice game. They just play a little bit different when Anya comes out of the game. They're a little bit more skilled offensively with Washington out there on the floor.
rise to it. Martin comes away with the seventh turnover by Purdue.
Nice defense by NC State on the last possession. Active hands. Defense is moving their feet, pressing the ball, and no one Purdue wants to go inside.
Interchangeable big man. Haas was getting rebounds. Now Hammond's doing it. And Martin takes it away again. He's one-on-one with Edwards. To the rim.
That was a careless play by Vince Edwards. He just casually tried to reverse the ball, not looking at the defense. And Martin just stepped right in the passing lane for an easy two.
Wolfpack out to a one-point edge. Edwards knocks down a big-time three. 16 for the freshman.
Well, if you're Washington, he's already made two threes in the game. You know the scouting report. You know the coaches talked about it at halftime. You've got to get up on that guy and make him put it on the ground.
Washington's got a quick answer. Tie ball game at 54.
These guys are just taking turns. It's like, hey, I'll let you shoot, you let me shoot.
Stevens. All wide of everything and out of bounds. Well, it's only the fifth time that these two teams have ever squared off, but it's looking good right now.
Benson Edwards right here. He's got those feet set, knocks down the three, and you've got Cal Washington stepping out, hands down, man down.
Counting the triples here in Mackey tonight. So far, these two teams have combined for 10 made three-point baskets. Stan Heath, Mike Cousins, glad to have you along. A 54-all ball game as NC State looks to improve to 7-0. Purdue looking to defend home court and go to 6-1. Seven times tonight. We've been tied seven times. The lead has changed hands. And once again, NC State with the opportunity to go back in front.
We've got a good ball game right here. Both teams competing at a high level.
At a crowded post as Cat Barber looks inside.
NC State going to what we call a triangle offense. You've got three guys inside working together. Because of the clock, they go right into the high ball screen action.
Washington, quite the follow on this box out, leads to two. He has 17 points.
Well, he has really been effective, productive in this game for NC State.
Came in averaging just seven in their first six games. Now, Octius, 0-for-2 from the floor tonight. A lot of contact, a look for Stevens. In and out. Taken away, Davis. Octius snares the offensive board.
That was really good hands by Davis on that defensive steal. He's got great anticipation on plays on the defensive end.
Haitian possession, Stevens, long two, at his foot of the line.
You know, he just had a big sigh of relief, like finally it went down. You know, but he was patient on that shot right there. The other one's just been a little bit quick. That time he set his feet, he let the defender go by on the shot fake and drilled it.
Shooters need that. They need to feel confident.
They need that. Yeah, he's a guy you could tell. I think once he gets his confidence going, he could be a factor down the stretch.
Octius got hit and they whistled a foul. Tomorrow, the ACC Big Ten Challenge back on ESPN. First, the Hawkeyes and North Carolina. And that's followed by freshman Jahlil Okafor and Duke taking on Frank Kaminsky and Wisconsin. Tomorrow on ESPN, the home court of college hoops. Don't overlook, though, Sam Decker, Justice Winslow matchup in that game. Tyus Jones, Trayvon Jackson. Another look at that foul.
You know, hard to tell right there is if there was contact above the head, you know, why they wouldn't look at that as a potential flagrant one. unless something was called sooner.
And it's the fourth on Octius, the graduate transfer from Colorado State, who takes a seat.
I'm not mad about this. You know, let these guys play.
Alston Turner trailing on the play. And he's whistled for foul number four. Double bonus for Purdue.
You got right here the screen at the top right here, and you've got the defender just tries to fight through it and creates that contact for the foul.
Yes, sir. Keep it up. Keep it up.
And out for Stevens. 8 points for him tonight. Turner with four fouls. Play the game.
This free throw shooting is going to be so big down the stretch. Purdue's been in the bonus almost since the 14, 13-minute mark in the first half. And I'm not sure they've capitalized on that enough with the free throw shooting they've had down in the last 7 minutes.
Boilermakers by one. Nobody playing the paint right now. Washington floats it. Haas loses it. Thompson's got it.
I think Mark Godfrey's trying to find something to get Haas away from the basket and make him defend.
Hard to do considering that Haas leads the country in fouls drawn per 40 minutes.
I like the way he ducks in. You know, he waits for the ball to come to him, and then he ducks in strong. You know, Matt Painter and his staff really works hard at teaching the duck in move for his big post players.
Free throws, not the strongest point for Haas entering the night. He was shooting 56% at the stripe tonight, a perfect 4 out of 4.
I guarantee you he's figuring some things out that he knows, and the coaches, I'm sure, are telling him, look, you're going to get fouled a lot, so every day after practice, let's get an extra 100 up so you can make people pay at the free throw line.
Thompson a three.
That was all set up by Vince Edwards. Vince Edwards drove the defense, didn't see anything, kind of a slow, fast break, and he's able to kick that ball back. Vince Edwards, a guy who can do a little bit of everything for his team, probes the defense, doesn't see anything, kicks it back for him. P.J. Thompson, the feet are set. 3-point shot, money.
Back in Indiana, Purdue on an 8-0 run. And let's take a look at the offense before the offense, Stan.
Yeah, let's watch P.J. Thompson right here. He's going to trail the play in what we call a primary fast break. It's not a fast break. He trails into the play, he steps into the shot, and he knocks down the 3-point shot.
Big shot there for Thompson, his first points of the night, and they come at a crucial time for Purdue. Boilers only lost this year against Kansas State out in Hawaii. Off to a very good start, and a young team as well.
You know, you wonder how long Mark Godfrey is going to keep DJ Anya on the bench. He's got those four fouls, but his size and presence is very needed to go up against Haas.
Whistle top of the key. And the crowd only continues to get louder here at Mackey Arena.
They got a legal screen call. There's a double pick. We call it the gate play. And as they're trying to close the gate on that play right there, they move. And that's a good call by the official.
Rafael Davis excited about foul number four against Lenard Freeman. Thompson, another three. Offensive board for Edwards.
Davis is the one guy, Rayfield Davis, that NC State's playing off to give a little bit more help in the paint.
A lob, and it's missed by Washington.
Good play by Trevor Lacy, hustling the ball down, and he gets rewarded.
Big time three for Lacy, 13 points now for the transfer.
Yeah, you're wondering down the stretch who the go-to guys are, no question. Trevor Lacy from North Carolina State is the go-to player on their team.
Why they brought him to Raleigh. And now the foul against Purdue. NC State down by three with the ball.
Let's watch Lacy here in this pull-up jump shot right here. He throws the lob. He misses a lot, but he drains the three by hustling down and getting that loose ball.
Purdue by three. They've played a lot inside tonight, but on the perimeter, it's been a freshman that's leading the way.
And Fitz Edwards has been the leading scorer for Purdue this season, and he does it a lot of different ways. He can drive to the basket. He's a good rebounder. He's already had 6 offensive rebounds today and 8 total, and he's draining the three-point shot, going 3 out of 4 from the three-point line.
Some big buckets. If you were to talk about Purdue in August, in September, in October, and say, who's the leading scorer going to be for the Boilermakers? You might hear A.J. Hammonds. You might hear Kendall Stevens. But probably nobody would have put their money on Vince Edwards.
No, you would not put your money on Vince Edwards, although the coaching staff was very high on Vince Edwards recruiting him. They felt he could come in and help, felt he could contribute at a high level, but they didn't expect him to be the leading scorer. And in this game, he's been consistent all year long, but I think he's taking his game to another level in this game. He's really consistent at that three-point line and playing with a lot of confidence.
3.5 to go here in West Lafayette, Indiana.
This ball almost has to touch Trevor Lacy's hands.
E.J. Anya, the big man, back on the floor, 4 fouls. Lacy for 3. Oh, my goodness.
Boy, he is tough. He is tough. I mean, he just created that three-point shot. He just sized up P.J. Hammonds and he just Thompson and just drilled it. It was good defense, better offense.
Bill Lack and Lamont Simpson now are going to have a look at the monitor just to see if his foot was on the line.
See right here, Trevor does a good job. He tries to take him off the dribble, doesn't have anything, sizes him up.
That's
and
a
just
2.
Raises up, knocks it down, but right, that's a 2-point shot. Well, he plays with a lot of confidence. He knows who he is. He knows he's the guy for NC State.
And Stan, I think that there's credit due on both sides of this matchup tonight. Lacy, the leading scorer on this team, 17 a game coming into tonight. What Matt Painter has asked P.J. Thompson, a freshman, to do tonight is no easy task either, and he's done pretty good.
Not at all. You know, both those guys, and they've rotated. They have Rayfield Davis on them as well, too. And P.J. has done a nice job. P.J. Thompson's done a nice job. He plays him a little bit different, gets up tighter and closer. But once he gets a little bit of space and he can elevate into a shot, there's nothing P.J. Thompson can do.
And it was ruled a 2-point field goal. As we saw, the left foot was inside the arc, so Purdue hangs on to a 1-point edge.
Boy, Purdue made that run. They went up by 8 points, and NC State just countered.
Right in for Stevens. He fades. Hammonds tips it. And Thompson at 5'10 with the offensive board. Timeout, Matt Painter. So you're going inside the huddle. You got a 1-point lead here. Well, Painter has been pretty calm tonight. How does he direct his team here?
Yeah, you know, Vince Edwards has been, you know, the guy in this particular game, but it wouldn't surprise me if they go to A.J. Hammonds. He talked about that when they were in Maui, and A.J. hadn't particularly had a great game, but he went to A.J. Hammonds against BYU. He scored the basket, and A.J. actually asked Coach, he said, hey, Coach, I didn't know you were going to go to me. I didn't know you had that kind of confidence. And Coach said, no, we got confidence in you. So I think he's going to go to A.J. because he's got confidence in him. He's a low post scorer. They'll play through him. He may get the shot, or because of the traffic, he may be able to kick it out and get something easy for his teammate.
So 11 points, 5 of 9 from the floor, as the Boilermakers hold on to a one-point lead, and they've led by as many as 9 tonight. NC State's largest advantage, 2. They run Stevens off the screen. Elbow jumper, no. And down. Back for Purdue.
That's two plays. You're getting down the stretch here, and you give up two offensive rebounds and a possession. NC State has got to clean things up on the defensive end.
Easy entry feed, uncontested. That's Davis to Hammonds.
That's way too easy. You know, he waited for the ball to swing to the weak side of the court, and he just sealed, and there was no resistance by either. He's got those fouls in. He's playing a little bit tentative, but that was too easy. He's got to play defense early and not late.
Down by 3, Mark Gottfried with the timeout. Wolfpack with 2 left. Coming up Saturday, interstate rivals take over the Commonwealth as Justin Anderson leads number 7 Virginia. Boy, that defense has been good. Shaka Smart and the high-energy VCU squad. It's the Hoos and VCU, a part of Jimmy V-Week, Saturday at 2 on ESPNU and the home court of College Hoops. Virginia, they're at number 4. They helped Rutgers to 26 points on Saturday.
That's unbelievable defense right there. I mean, they do a great job defensively. Tony Bennett, he's instilled his system. And defensively, they play the pack line defense. And they are very physical. They talk, they help. But 26 points?
It's a football score.
Yeah, the Auburn, Alabama, the score in football was a lot higher than that by far.
So 10 fouls against North Carolina State, Purdue in the double bonus. 8 against the Boilermakers, 1-1 if they foul. 2:10 to go is A.J. Hammonds, a season high of 13. And a team high of 16 for Vince Edwards.
You can see right here, they've switched Rafael Davis now as a sign to Trevor Lacy. And I would think they're going to go to him on this play.
They say he stepped out of bounds on the baseline. Is that the call there?
Yeah, I'd like to see that. You know, if he established 2 feet in before he catches it. Mark Godfrey's trying to get an explanation from Lamont Simpson.
So he came, was it because he came out of bounds and then was the next player to touch the ball?
Yeah, but you know, once you establish 2 feet back in bounds, you're good. It's not like the football wide receiver, you go out of bounds and you're illegal the rest of the play.
Right. Oh, 1:40, Boilermakers by 3. Hammonds battles with Anya in the post.
He's open. Give it to him. Give
it to him. Double team.
That should have went right back to A.J. Hammonds. He just scored on the last basket. But he's got to demand that basketball. It's crunch time right now.
Fires. Boilermaker basketball under 1 minute to go.
Big rebound right there. Big rebound. Be interesting if they foul or they wait. They're going to play this possession through and get a stop. They need a stop right here. NC State, they got to get down in a defensive stance.
Shot clock and game clock separated by 19 seconds. Davis drives. Out of bounds. Off of Hammonds.
What a great block by Kyle Washington. Davis had a clear path. He's beat his man to the rim. And that was all ball right there. You see, he got right through the defense, but Kyle Washington with the long arms. And he's able to block. Not only block that, but knock it off Rafael Davis to get that possession.
So Matt Painter takes a timeout with a 3-point lead. Trevor Lacy tonight, on the other hand, has been quite a handful. 15 points on 6 of 10 shooting.
Well, he's such a gifted offensive player. He can play off the bounce. And he, at 6'3", 6'4", when he elevates, if you have a smaller defender, he just shoots right over the top of you. You can see right here with a nice curl, moving without the basketball. His teammates find him with a good pass. He just takes it right into the paint again, elevates, knocks down that mid-range jump shot.
This relationship goes deep between Mark Gottfried and Trevor Lacy. When he was in eighth grade, his first scholarship offer came from the head coach at Alabama.
And that always helps you.
It was Mark Gottfried.
You recruit those guys early, you build those relationships, and then, you know, he's a hometown kid, he wants to stay in state, so he does that. Things don't quite go the way he likes. So right away, who's the call? The guy who recruited him in the eighth grade, Mark Gottfried.
So the ACC with one win on the board tonight. NC State trying to make it two, but they're down by three with the basketball.
There's a lot of time right now, so they can go for the two. They don't need the three right away.
Our defense. And on the floor, Davis trying to go step for step with Lacy. Picks up the whistle. His third foul. And number 9 against Purdue, 1-1.
Yeah, really smart play by Trevor Lacy. He felt Rafael Davis playing extremely tight. And any kind of contact, he was going to create even more contact so he could draw a foul and get himself to the free throw line.
Lacy, 0-2 at the line tonight. Loose ball. Who's got it? Anya. Stripped away. And the Boilermakers get control. A foul called against the Wolfpack.
Purdue is pretty fortunate right here. Trevor Lacy with the missed free throws. Loose ball. But the big guy brought it down low. BJ and I brought the ball down low because of that. Ball got deflected away and created that turnover.
7.1. And free throw from Hammonds. A 4-point lead.
I know Trevor Lacy's not happy with himself. He'd love to get those free throws back. It's a good job by the big fella, A.J. Hammonds, to step up to the line. The first one was the big one.
Barber, 5 seconds. And that's it. NC State handed its first loss of the year. They're 6-1. And the Boilermakers tack on another win for the Big Ten. Purdue, 6-1. To the Big Ten, now 6-1 against the ACC this season. Coming up next, college football playoff top 25, brought to you by AT&T. Fun one with Stan Heath, Mike Cousins. Thanks for watching. On behalf of our ESPN crew, we say so long from Mackey Arena in West Lafayette, Indiana.